الداوة من ماء. فنظر رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فلم يرى شيئا يستتر له. في شيء لو جلس وكشف عن ثوبه ليتبرز صلى الله عليه وسلم ستظهر عورته لخادمه، وهو لم يرى أحد منه أبدا شيء يسوءه، وكان يكره أن يرى أحد منه شيئا يسوءه. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم was on a trip as Imam Muslim collected on the authority of Jabir ibn Abdullah. He was on a trip. They stopped in a very wide valley. And in that valley, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم has to respond to the call of the nature, as they said. He wants to go for bowel movement. He looked around and his servant followed him with something, collect some water to for his wudu. He looked around, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he found nothing to hide himself behind. And he used to hate anyone to see in improper position. So he found only two small trees, one in the west, one in the east. So, فَإِذَا شَجَرَتَانِ بِشَاطِئِ الْوَادِ فَانْطَلَقَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ إلى إحداهما فأخذ بغصن من أغصانها فقال للشجرة انقادي بإذن الله فانقادت معه كالبعير الخشوش. البعير اللي عليه أثقال يمشي من فهي مشت تحدث صوتا مثلها. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم found those two trees, but too far from one another. He went to one of them, hold a branch, and said, come with me by the will of Allah. So it followed him as if he is pulling a camel from its leash. حتى أتى الشجرة الأخرى فأخذ بغصن من أغصانها وقال لها انقاذي علي بإذن الله. And he did the same with the second tree. So he pulled this, for example, from here to here, and he got the second one. He wanted to put balls next to one another to hide himself behind. فالقادم معه كذلك حتى إذا كان بالنصف مما بينهما لأم بينهما جعلهما شجرة واحدة يعني جمعهما فقال التئما علي بإذن الله يعني استراني صلى الله عليه وسلم فقال he said after he pulled both trees to the middle distance between both of them he said get together and scream. That's what he said صلى الله عليه وسلم. So they get together and they screamed him well. Jabir is continuing his speech. Jabir was a believer. Jabir didn't ask Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for a miracle. But Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam needed that to happen to screen himself from being exposed. So he did it and Allah helped him. After the hadith, we never hear that Jabir become more believer than before. We didn't hear anything about that. We didn't hear that Jabir, after he saw that special miracle, he became in a faith status or a level of faith more than Abu Bakr, for example. Never. It didn't increase anything because he believed in that man. That is the messenger of Allah. And I want everybody to believe in the man, not in the miracles, because miracles all vanish, all gone. And if the remembrance of Rasulullah as a prophet, as a sent messenger from Allah, will be vanished from your heart, that means we will lose faith at least zero believer. Yes, you're not gathered, but you are zero. We don't want to reach that level. We need, if someone will come to learn, because he loved Allah and he loved Rasulullah and he wants to learn. From among the knowledge, if he asks about if any miracle happened, yes, such and such. Just as a matter of confirmation, but not as a reason to believe in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And if I bring any Christian or any Kafir who's looking for the truth, and I keep telling him, Muhammad moved two trees and made them one tree to screen him while he's urinating or whatever. What does that mean to him? But when you give him a translated copy of the Quran, probably many, they respond good, positively to translation of Quran, not the real Quran. And we, Muslims, we don't respond to the command of Rasulullah while we knew it. We heard it, not from one imam, from 10 imams so far in this masjid. And we continue to ignore what they taught us. Some, not all, not the people, some of us. So what else we need? We have the Quran. We have plenty confirmation after confirmation after confirmation that this man was a prophet. And we still disobeying him. Plenty of people, they don't believe that they will be standing before Allah. They don't believe in that. They said, now you're going to talk about with me about death, about resurrection. We didn't see anybody came back. This is what, how they respond. They are Muslims. And this is how they respond to you. So what happened with Jabir after that? Jabir said, and after Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam finished what he was doing, he ordered the both trees go back. So the trees walked on themselves on their own, and they went back to their original spots. Now two miracles, three miracles in 5 minutes. Who will stand the whole night for those two miracles? Let's proceed. Probably you need more. في جنبات مكة ثبت الله قلبه قلب حبيبه صلى الله عليه وسلم في مواجهة المحن بآية من هذا الجنس. فقد جاء جبريل عليه السلام إلى رسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم وهو حزين قد خضب وجهه بالدماء. قد ضربه بعض أهل مكة فقال ما لك؟ النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم هو وجهه يدمي. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم another miracle. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم جبرائيل came to him while the face of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم was bleeding. So جبرائيل said to him, what happened to you, Muhammad? Why your face is bleeding? He knows. But it's a matter of cooling off the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Jibreel, if he behaved from his own, was able to just jump up on those guys and terminate all of them. But he is having a dialogue with Rasulullah. كان يستطيع جبرائيل لو أنه يتحرك من تلقاء نفسه أو يتصرف من عندي نفسه لقفز على هؤلاء الناس ودمرهم تدميرا. فهو لا ينزل إلا بوحي أو دمار. جبريل عليه الصلاة والسلام فقال فعل بي هؤلاء وفعلوا. يعني حكى له القصة أنه بعض الناس اعتدوا عليه بالضرب صلى الله عليه وسلم. So he complained, he told him the story that some people they did such and such with him till his face was bleeding. So on. فقال جبريل للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أتحب أن أريك آية يا محمد؟ So جبريل to make like entertainment to him, to make him cool off. He said, what about if I show you a miracle, oh Muhammad? He said, yes, show me. فنظر إلى شجرة من وراء الوادي. قال ادعو تلك الشجرة يا محمد. فدعاها فجاءت تمشي حتى قامت بين يديه. قال للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قل لا ترجع. فقال لها النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ارجعي. فرجعت حتى عادت مكانها. فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم حسبي. يعني نسيت الألم اللي عندي. بس نسي انه ضرب صلى الله عليه وسلم بأبي وأمي. هو كان يضرب فتنزل آية تثبت فؤاده. أنت نبي. معنى هذه الآية أنت نبي. مؤيد. اصبر على الدماء ولا تشتكي. لا تشتكي. وأنتم جميعا وأنا إياك أن تشتكي الله لأحد. So, what was the point behind that miracle? رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم was sad, was complaining to Jibreel about what happened to him. So he wanted to tell him that you are supported by Allah. So forget your pain. You have a certain goal. You have to reach the goal. Regardless how much painful the way to the goal. So forget about your pain. So after he said to him, do you see that far tree at the end of the valley? He said, yes. He said, call it. So Rasulullah said, come to me. It came to him. Till it stand in front of him. And he said to him, now order the tree to go back. So he said to the tree, go back. It went back. So he said to Jibreel, after he found the tree, went back, I forgot my name. I don't need anything else. It was like entertainment, just entertainment. So, if the miracle to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, after he received the wahy and still receiving the wahy, the miracle was as a matter of entertainment to him. What I recite to you of miracles to you more than entertainment. But it won't increase your iman. Unless you have no iman of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the Quran didn't affect you, probably this would affect you, but if the Quran, which never changed from 1450 years so far till today, didn't make you to respond better to Allah, you think this story will affect you? It's easy for you, shaitan, to say, it's just stories, no proof. Who cares for Muslim or Bukhari? I don't really think that's an authentic hadith. So you will find many ways to get out of it. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what happened to him made him relax. That's it. Forget his pain. And he want to say to him, you are supported. Don't complain about Allah to anyone, even if he were Jibreel. And none of us, starting with myself, supposed to complain about Allah. Don't. If someone will say to you, what happened, you say, Alhamdulillah, I'm kind of sick. Pray for me. But don't say, I don't know why I'm always sick. Everybody older than me, they keep going back and forth on their legs, and I cannot do that. Why me? Don't complain about Allah, or you will lose your iman. That means you don't believe in Him. But one of the the pillars of Iman, because the Iman has pillars. What are the pillars in Iman? In Bukhari and Muslim. In Hadith Jibreel. Thamar Iman. An tu'min billah, malaikati, wa kutubi, wa rusuli, wal yawm al akhir, wal qadari khayrihi wa sharrihi. You have to accept the decree of Allah, whether it is good to you or it look bad to you. It's part, it's one of the pillar of Iman. So, dear brothers, if the Quran, because you are far away from the Quran, you don't read the Quran. Probably you read the Quran on Friday only. And you insist to read Al-Kahf and that's it. May Allah reward you. But is it enough? If one of you now, old or young, have a fiancé, or made the contract of nikah with a girl, and he's so excited to move her to his house, but he calls her on the phone because she's in a different country, or she send a message to him full of love. فلو أرسلت لك مخطوبتك أو محبوبتك رسالة عبر البلاد تبثك شوقها فستقرأ الجواب مرة اثنان وعشرة وقد تحفظه عن ظهر قلب. أنا لازلت أذكر خطاباتي الأولى لعروسي قبل أن تأتي إلى أمريكا سنة 76 76 ل 78 فاكر الجوابات كلها، ولو عايز اعيد كتابتها تاني اكتبها تاني، لاني كنت اقرا الجواب الواحد منها 10 مرات او 20 مره حتى احفظه، والان فشلت في حفظ القران الكريم كله. I still memorize the letters of that deceased wife 1976 till 1978. I'm still remembering most of the text of what she used to send to me from Egypt while I was in America. It was marvelous talk. And I failed to memorize the whole Quran. Probably the letters she sent to me, about 600 pages like the Quran. The point is, if you love something so much, you keep updating yourself with that. And I hide you no secret. If I tell you, وَأَنَا لَا أَخْفِيكَ سِرًّا أَنْ أَقُولَ لَكَ وَاللَّهِ مَا قَرَأْتُ الْقُرْآنَ مَرَّة بَعْدَ مَرَّة إِلَّا وَجَدْتُ فِي الْمَرَّة الْجَدِيدَةِ مَفَاتِيحَ جَدِيدَةً فَأَرْجَعْ إِلَى التَّفَاسِيرِ فلا أجدها في بعضها وأرجع إلى تفاسير أخرى فأجدها فيها فأفرح أن الله يعلمني ويفتح لي أبواب الخير. اقرأ القرآن. أنا أعلم شباب كثير ما مسك القرآن لمدة عام منذ رمضان حتى الآن ما أمسك بالقرآن. Read the Quran. Read the Quran. If you cannot read it, if you won't write it, stand in the night with it. Today I gave you 3 miracles about trees. And we still have plenty of miracles of Rasulullah. So you got 3 miracles. Can you stand 3 hours tonight and the night for Allah? Because of, as a price back for each miracle happened to Rasulullah. Invite your son to come to the classes. Invite your wife to come to the classes. Invite your daughter. Invite your neighbor. Invite yourself to come to the classes. Forget about the person who speaks. Come to the knowledge. If you're not convinced with the knowledge, I cannot force you to come. But if you think that he is giving you true through knowledge, come and take it from him, regardless if you click with him or you don't click with him. Come to the knowledge. Don't come to the knowledge. Sit to a respected sheikh you love from your country and listen to him. Increase yourself in knowledge and decrease the gap between you and the time of Rasulullah. Because if it will be vanished, it will be no distance between you and the time of the life of Rasulullah, you will automatically respond to any sunnah from his command. Till here we will stop. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ala nabi Muhammad wa ala ashabi wa ala bayti. Subhanakallahu wa bihamdik. Shadu an la ilaha illa anta. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.